washed down.
Didn't get washed, it got pushed.
How?
Because multiple events.
No, absolutely not.
You wouldn't have those layers on the bottom.
Yeah, you would.
It's the little stuff on the bottom.
Nope.
Say,
oh, no!
I've mined too many
rivers. No, no!
I disagree.
He's crazy. Have to put spurs on to drive down this road.
Yeah, you're not joking, Freddy. This road's pretty rough, buddy.
Freddy and Juan are in British Columbia, deep in the Kootenay Rockies, en route to the Nip and Tuck claim, owned by reclusive miner Stephen Lathridge of Washing Out.
Hey,
easy. Hey, killers.
Easy. No biting.
Be
no
nice.
Boy. Hey, that's enough, you guys.
Come on.
Stop it. You're disrupting our tranquility. Good to see you guys.
Freddy.
Oh, man.
Wow. Steve, I assume.
Yeah, this is James, my
James.
Partner.
Juan.
Nice hey, Juan.
Oh, welcome to the Nip and Tuck, guys.
That's why you call it because of the biting dogs.
So how long have you been out here, Steve?
Inside the gate at the ball, it's about spring of 2008. Everything up here that you see, so the camp, the operation just below camp, and this operation, 2013.
Steve's Nip and Tuck mine is a small placer claim on 50 acres with one excavator and a small trommel wash plant, mining rights, but is unable to build a permanent home here.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life. Really enjoy a shower, go without one for a little while.
Steve's goal before winter? Recover enough gold to buy a plot of land.
I found a little piece of land, but that's like tens of thousands of dollars. And in order to buy that piece of land, I'm gonna need 30 ounces.
So how much have you produced this year?
Oh my goodness sakes, what do you think, James?
A little bit over 9 ounces, I'd say.
It's not that good.
So what you're saying is you basically in the next month and a half, you got to get another 20 ounces is where you got
to
be.
Another 20, 30 if I want to buy 30. A piece of land. This lucrative. I've not been finding that much gold. The more in debt I go, the farther off my goal of a place to live is.
Not having enough help, the mine is a one-man operation, with friend James DeRaspi volunteering part-time.
People often ask me, why aren't I at my own claims or something? Well, there's many reasons, but once we became friends, I truly wanted to help him, and, you know, I know for him.
Do you have any of the gold from here? Because I'm looking at 2.5-inch holes in your trommel.
Yeah, and I am glad that they are that big. 36-ounce nugget found up here back in the day. What is the chances that that was the only one? I think slim.
The Nip and Tuck sits from the site of British Columbia's most famous gold rush at Wild Horse River. In 1863, American prospectors discovered 48 gold there, worth around $2 billion today.
If you dug a hole up here, you would find gold if you washed that gravel. Over there, up. It's all over the place. Getting me all worked up here. This is some stuff that's just recently, and this is what came out of that.
Well, you got some finds in there.
Yeah, you do.
Not much, though, right?
I love them, but I gotta say, he needs to be convinced about how much fine gold there is. There's much.
No. There might be more that you're losing.
I'd rather have a 5-gallon bucket full of that small stuff because a bucket of nuggets is half full of air.
I kind of look at it like not too concerned about dropping the penny when I got a handful of toonies.
He's all about the nuggets.
And is this what you've collected this year so far?
No, this is last year.
He's had to give for him to live. We've had to
sell. So you've just been barely getting by then, is what you're saying.
The reason that I've managed to get this far as a placer operation is by using. So,
Well, you know, all we can do is try to help.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah, absolutely.
And part of that, we got to watch it run. Let's see what we got going on. And
we'll get her fired up and
you know, run it.
For the first test, Steve will run the plant for 4 hours.
First bucket, Juan.
Full of gold. 10, 20, 30-ounce nuggets of gold.
Most mining operations use an excavator, a rock truck, and a loader to get the pay out of the ground and to the plant, but not
Steve. Everything with the one
hailing, doing hailing, digging pay.
Basically, he's hauling pay. He's doing it all with one machine.
Steve digs his pay dirt from just 6 feet down in a small cut and feeds it directly into his makeshift wash plant. A 44-inch diameter made from a recycled propane tank with a narrow 10-foot sluice box to catch the gold.
You got your phone with you?
Yeah.
How long it takes them to finish one bucket?
You're gonna have to speed it up.
Yep.
There we go. 5 minutes for a half a yard. 10 minutes for a yard.
Yep.
So he's
so
doing
six.
He'll do 6 yards.
6 yards an hour is what he's doing, yep.
I'm pretty cautious when it comes to this stuff. Experience has told me to slow and easy wins the race, right?
Not always. There is no slow and easy. You got to run. You got a short season. In that short season, you run as much as you can.
Let's don't talk about it. Feed it. Feed it.
This runner, man.
I like him, but he's going to drive me nuts. Ready?
Yeah.
Gold in that bucket.
This guy's definitely got gold fever.
Swear there's gold in this bucket.
Look at that slurry coming out, Freddy.
Yeah.
Look how much we're losing.
Yeah, look how dirty those rocks are.
Yeah. I bet you we're losing fines out of the end of that.
Yeah, I would agree. You're dirty. Look at that.
You know, the reason he's not seeing a whole lot of fines is probably because he's not even catching them.
Stuck to these rocks.
Not even giving him a chance. Should we go wash it?
Yeah, let's pan it.
Look at that, Fred.
Yep.
Every bit of that should have gone right through that trommel.
Yep, every
piece. Should have been smooth.
Yep.
I bet you those guys found gold in that. I would not doubt it.
There is gold in it.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces there.
That's not good, Freddy. That wasn't even a full pan.
No, that's a lot of gold out the end of that trommel.
This is off the end of the sluice run, Freddy.
Yeah. You see something? Right there, one piece.
Two.
Yeah, little itty-bitty one. Gold, but it's still getting lost.
Steve's operation is built to catch monster nuggets, but he's losing fine gold from both the trommel loose.
There he is, fiddling around.
He always seems to stop at nitpick on stuff, huh?
He just needs...
Baby, run.
Steve, last bucket.
After 4 hours, it's time.
I was hoping to see a couple 30-ouncers in there.
Oh, my
shit.
God, you and me both.
Man, I was hoping.
You and me both.
That's a little cute ouncer I wanted to see, but.
Well, shall we get her cleaned out?
Yep, let's clean it up.
As James and Juan clean the mats, Steve gives Freddy a...
Looks pretty rustic. Modified shipping container.
It's not very fancy. This is my home, right here.
It's a bit tight.
It's cozy in here, there's no question, but I can't continue living like this. I need hot and cold running water. I need a place like most people live.
It's for sure.
Yeah, no, it isn't.
Moment of truth, huh?
Well,
all right.
Let's see what it did, guys. Dump it in the pan, let's see what you... .13 of an ounce.
Not horrible.
I mean, it was only a short run.
$270 worth of gold there for 4 hours.
Steve ran just 24 yards. That means he's getting some gold for every 100 yards of pay dirt. Less than 50% of what most mines produce. He's barely making enough to survive alone, buy the land he needs to build a home.
What we want to see is more of that fine gold. We know you have it.
Yeah.
We know it's here.
Do you think it is here?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's right there. There's some.
But I'm going to tell you right now, the way you're tuned up right now, the fact that we caught this, I bet there's quite a bit more. We're going to sit down and come up with some. We'll run it by you and see if you're game with it.
We'll see you here in a little
bit. All right,
we'll
talk to you in a bit.
Don't spill your gold.
No, work too hard for it.
Trip.
Trip.
Boy, he's got a bunch of puking material out the end.
And we panned it, and there's gold in every bit of it. Right?
Yep. Gold coming out of the end of the sluice, too.
Yeah.
Got two colors there.
So, on both ends. And the crazy thing is, he heard a story about someone getting a 35-ounce nugget. Who knows when or where in this
street. Or over the years, if he would have not worried about that 35-ounce nugget, I guarantee he would have caught more than 35 ounces of extra gold.
Oh, easy. Yeah. Easy. Sounds like he's that type of ideas, and, you know... I'm hoping that he's open to change.
If he's not open to much change, there isn't much we can do for him.
Yeah.
What do you think, Wano? You know, without that trauma tools, and you know his dream is to find that nugget.
I know.
Freddy and Juan have four more days to rescue Steve Latham's operation. Enough gold to build his dream home before winter.
The quickest and the easiest and the most cost-effective thing to do would be to wrap that drum and screen it down a little bit. His dream, like you said.
Yeah.
So I think the next best option is we build a secondary screening area here. Build another sluice, and then we'll come into this trommel drum and we'll do slip.
That's going to take, though, we're going to have to put a whole new pump in, right?
Yeah.
Because he doesn't have enough water now to run this sluice box.
Yeah, true. Right? True. We're still going to have to do some dams inside.
Yeah, well, I think we put right here.
Yeah, and maybe in the beginning.
Right here, it needs a dam in it, too, a ring in it.
Yeah.
Right there.
Agreed.
So we end up putting three rings in, adding a pump, and then building them.
Steve's wash plant is set up to catch nuggets with 2.5-inch holes in the barrel. But it's losing fine end and the sluice box. Freddy and Juan's solution? Add an extra sluice run specifically for fine gold recovery. Cut a series of half-inch slits in the trommel to allow the fine gold to drop into the new sluice. Add three steel dams inside material, allowing more time to wash the gold off the rocks.
I know a concern for him is what this is going to cost because he's a metal type of miner.
Living in a shipping container, want.
But reality is, there's quite a bit of work that goes into
it. I don't
this.
Know if we got enough time to do it. Let's go talk to him about it.
All right, let's do it.
Get a warm bed this winter.
Yeah.
Freddy and Juan must convince Steve to focus on fine gold, but their fixes won't come cheap.
How's it going, guys? Well, we watched you run there.
There's a couple issues. We totally get why you want to screen so big, you know, the chance of being able to catch that bigger nugget. Yeah. But we're really worried that you're losing because you are screened so big. We actually got a couple different ideas for that, but one of them is that we actually want to build a new sluice for fine gold.
Rigged up just for your finer gold.
Strictly for fine gold, yeah. It's in your trommel.
Yeah.
Sluice you got
in
now.
In front of that for the finer gold.
Yeah. It's still there, so you can hopefully achieve your dream of that monster nugget.
Yes.
And the other one's going to be gold, right?
In order to be able to make that work, we're going to have to add another pump. You don't even have enough water right now for the sluice you have.
Right.
Yeah. So do you think cutting these is going to help reduce the water loss out of the end?
Nope.
Something else we're going to have to do.
Juan's baffles inside.
Yes.
Are going to do that.
So what we want to do is they hit a dam.
Slows it down.
And then it has to get, it either goes over the dam or has to go down through the screen.
Either way, it's going to increase your gold. Now for the kicker, though.
It sounds pretty.
That's where we're going.
The material we're going to need to buy is going to be about $3,500.
$3,500. There's a few odds and ends of scrap metal around here. Maybe you guys have a look around, see if you can.
Hopefully there's ways to keep costs down.
So we'll try. You know what, though? Water and myself talked and labor. We're going to donate our time. Okay. We don't want to see you living in a shipping container. Pay for his material.
Take me a second here.
Deal then?
Absolutely.
Let's do it.
Deal?
Absolutely. Sounds great.
Fine man. Fine man. Fine man.
Thank you.
Wow. Well. This could be life-changing for Steve. It really could, you know. Hopefully they're going to be a lot more gold, which means more money, which means him being getting closer to his goal of having a place to call his own.
Blown away, like, oh my goodness. If I've been throwing away as much gold as they believe I've been throwing away, and after the next few days I'm not throwing that gold, that should allow me to realize my dream of having a little piece of property, which is just, again, beyond my wildest dreams.
Steve's poured everything in, and really, you know, this guy's kind of stuck in his way. He's based his complete mining plan on the hope and dream that he's going to catch a 35-ounce nugget. It's kind of come in here and tried to change that. So what we're going to do is concentrate on the fine gold for him. If we're going to be able to catch more of it in the system we're building.
While Juan gets to work on dams, Freddy and Steve explore this gold-rich land.
This country looks a lot like where I'm from in Colorado, the mountains and stuff. What got you started into gold mining?
I had gem fever before I had the gold fever. Went in remission. The gold fever took over. I am chronically stricken now. Treasure fever, that's it.
chase monster nuggets. They head for the side of the old mining town of Fisherville.
You lead the way. I'll follow you.
Yeah, just down this way.
In 1863, word got out that there was gold on the Wild Horse River, and thousands of fortune-seeking prospectors rushed to settle. They weren't disappointed. The land was rich with 48 tons of nuggety gold.
I would not be surprised to see a piece of gold sitting right there. I would not be surprised to see that at all.
When it was found Fisherville was sitting on the richest deposits, the buildings were simply picked higher, allowing miner Mike Reynolds to mine the 36-ounce nugget that Steve dreams of repeating. But within 2 years, despite 50 tons of gold, the prospectors moved on, leaving Fisherville a ghost town.
These were the guys that started it. These were the guys that laid the groundwork for those that come after. And we are tomorrow's old timers.
Well, the best way to find gold is to follow what the old timers did.
The source of the gold that fed the rush has never been found. It's this big score that Steve has set his sights on.
This would be the lower end of what would have been Fisherville. That the source of the gold that fed the rush on the Wild Horse came out of Boulder Creek. Basically, that gully right there is where Boulder Creek flows out. Mine is at the base of that mountain.
Okay. You can have a spot here that'd be good. Maybe not up in that higher stuff, but down on the bottom, looking at it.
So being how close proximity to here, I know I'm on it. It's just getting it, right?
If gold is everywhere, it wouldn't be worth nothing.
Isn't that the truth?
He's a character, is what he is. He's got these big dreams, but is there enough gold here? Well, that's up to him. I mean, it's his dream, I think, to find that big piece of gold, but whether there's any of it here, I don't know.
These are the rings that are gonna go inside the trommel. And what we'll do is we'll get them all welded in, put corner gussets, and what they're gonna do is gonna slow so that material that's rushing down the trommel actually has a chance to get loose.
There it is.
There they are.
Let's have a look in your cut.
After history of the area, Freddy investigates Steve's pay to see if the potential for a monster nugget payday is really here.
What are you seeing?
I'm seeing glacial till.
Respectfully, I disagree. When I start cutting into this, it's consistent. When I dig a hole down there, it's a hole up here.
It would be.
Now, if you get up further upstream, that is absolutely glacial till. It's a different consistency. This is completely different.
Well, like whether it was a slide at the end or this is just glacial till, these are those properties that would push in front of that glacier.
Glacial tills. As a solid glacier wall bulldozes material down a valley, it scatters ground to the front and sides, making gold deposits. But if a river runs through these scattered deposits, its flow concentrates the gold on the riverbed, making it easier to find. Up is reworking.
See, this has never been reworked. This is in place, so.
This is as it lays when it got washed down.
It didn't get washed, it got pushed.
I'm fairly convinced, with all due respect, I'm vastly more experienced at this mine site.
When a strain,
I can't see how this would have got pushed in because you wouldn't have those layers on the...
How? Because multiple events, right?
Why aren't your boulders on bedrock?
It's not the big ones that are on the bottom.
The stream
system. The little stuff on the bottom.
Nope.
Same thing here.
Nope. I've mined too many rivers.
I'm just not convinced that this, number one, was pushed in, and number two, was reworked. You're saying
it's never been reworked. It's never pushed in here.
But when you start... Coupling that with the speed it would take to wash all this stuff in here?
That wasn't washed in, though.
I do respectfully disagree. What on the bottom event? Why is it just clay on the bottom?
What that is glacial silt. That was one event. And then you have that boulder layer there. That was a second event. Four different events have happened, not counting the event that originally put the gold into the bedrock. I tell you what, I'll bet you $1,000 like the best.
I don't have to know that.
Okay, a case of beer. It wasn't put in here with a massive water flow.
With all due respect, Mr. Dodge, I am not convinced. There's no bet. I ain't got $1,000 to start whistling away. I want to be honest and get their honest opinion. So disagreement, it never hurt. It helps bring the cream to the surface or the gold to the bottom, if you will.
Personally, I don't think they've been reworked. Actually, I know what that means is the gold in his bedrock It was laid in there before what's in the gravels on top.
Unable to help Steve locate the Freddy will have to focus on modifying Steve's wash plant.
Hopefully make it where he doesn't have to sleep in a shipping container through the winter, but... making them some new Nugget ruffles, because they don't have...
There's just 3 days left in the rescue. Freddy is in a race to fix off-grid miner Steve Latham's wash plant.
Got expanded metal there, so if he does magically find that 30-ounce nugget, he may not catch it the way the sluice box is set up now.
So they wreck monster nuggets up here, and that makes my heart sing, because I know there's big, big, big gold in here. I know it.
Those are done.
He still needs to be convinced about the fine gold, but small gold weighs heavy, and he said if he's got a goal as well as living costs, every gram counts.
The brand new sluice should be the solution to catch gold.
It would have been a lot less work to screen that trommel down to a smaller size, but at the same time, that would destroy his dream of catching that nugget, which may or may not be in the deposit. So we're gonna try to get that smaller material going down this sluice box instead of trying to compete with those monster boulders that are going this box.
This is gonna be the new side. What that side's gonna be, we're gonna have a whole new undershoot on this side of the trommel. What we're gonna do is we're gonna, and those slits that we're gonna cut in there is gonna allow that fine material to drop down into this pan and actually come into the new sluice run. So in essence, what we're doing is we're making a mold trommel so we can have our fine gold come down the one sluice and then our chunky nuggety gold on the other side.
While the wash plant is down for repairs, Steve gets piling pay.
Stuff is bulletproof. Wearing my teeth, burning through them in no time.
And you're wearing the teeth out on your excavator?
Yeah, I was just rubbing the bedrock. I couldn't dig into it at all. Well, these have only been on a month, and they're already showing some pretty severe signs of wear. It's well over $1,000 to get these welded on, and I think they took the shortcut.
They took the shortcut, yep.
Put them on.
I'll show you how to just keep putting hard face on these teeth every couple days.
Freddy has a fix that is a fraction of the cost of new teeth.
We're just building meat up, right?
Upon
it. And there, we're just building this up. Here, run a pass over the top of mine. It doesn't have to be pretty. Yep, now throw another one there.
Another one on top of that one.
Yep. So do that every couple days. It's going to make these last a hell of a lot.
Easy fix.
Yep.
Easy fix. Man, I never even thought of that. Hard facing on the teeth. It's so obvious. It takes somebody with a little bit. Wait a second. Why don't you try this? And I think Freddy's come up with a pretty good solution for that.
3 days remaining. The next priority is to adapt the trommel to catch fine gold.
So what we're gonna do, we're gonna cut a series of slots. You're gonna do is gonna allow that fine material to drop through the trommel into the new sluice run.
Hey Juan, before you start cutting, can I get a favor? Can you tap this out for me?
Yeah, one second.
More. Keep going.
More.
More. How does that look on your end?
Looks sexy. I'd run it.
Back plate in here, so that water, when it comes through the slits Juan's gonna cut, all the water goes where we want it to go.
First one, only about 6,000 more to go.
Freddy works on the water supply.
Adding a new sluice in. Juan's cutting slits for it, for the fine gold, to get that smaller material away from those 2-inch boulders he's got going down his other sluice box. By doing other sluice in, we've got to add more water. So we're gonna build a manifold to get the water from the pump that we got coming.
We need to spin it now. A little more. Good. We're about quarter done. Don't tell nobody about that one. That's 5/8. That's our set. We're not taking anybody to the moon with this.
Oh my goodness, taking shape. I am so excited. We already losing gold. Stuff flying out the end. So I'm really happy that they're leaving those holes as they are. They recognize that I have a dream. And there they can to help me realize it, so I'm stoked.
We've got a hell of a lot of stuff to still do here and not a hell of a lot of time to get it done in. So we're gonna weigh at it and hopefully time works in our favor. We've got to get almost everything done today so we can run tomorrow. No time to waste here now.
At the Nip and Tuck, it's the penultimate day, and the pressure.
Today's going to be a busy day.
Juan cut these rings out on his burn table. We're going to put these in here to slow that water and material that was shooting out the end of the trommel down the sluice box where it's supposed to go.
Oh, man, my back hurts today. Oh, I'm an old man.
Before fitting the baffles, Juan needs to smooth the trommel to ensure a snug fit. Freddy pushes forward on the new sluice.
These are, call them ribs for the sluice bar. Just grinding them up so they'll weld a bit easier.
You mind if I have a look at what you're up to here?
Oh, building that new sluice box for your...
Look at that, oh man.
So it's flat, see the ribs around it, cradle it, hold it together.
Oh, it's beefy. Oh man. Oh, that is gookum than anything I ever had.
One fits the baffles that will slow the water flow and divert the fine gold. Freddy is finishing.
Damn. Look at that.
Right on my hat.
Look how much fun he's having. How could I take that away from him? All right, we got the machine here, so hopefully that can help.
Steve's borrowed a smaller excavator to bring in the new sluice.
Don't bend it.
Don't dent it.
Straight back.
Whoa. Oh, you put a dent in it.
Bend it, he said.
All right, good.
Down. All right.
Perfect, guys. Thank you. You good with it?
Yeah, it's uno, tres, cuatro.
Abajo un poquillo.
Huh? No.
I like it.
We're good.
This is the most skookum sluice box that has ever graced the steps of the Nip-Tuck gold mine. Oh my goodness sakes. I can't wait to see it with some expanded metal, fine gold spilling all through there.
To adjust the pitch of the new fine gold troll water flow and pay dirt, Freddy and Juan have a cheap but effective hack.
We got the new sluice box in place. We're getting it set up right now. We're getting the right bid. Was Freddy actually got these two little bottle jacks, welded them onto a plate, and we're going to use that as our adjustment.
We can adjust the pitch or adjust the sluice side to side with it to get it perfectly level that we want on it.
You know, it's kind of a cool idea. It's something cheap.
$30 worth of material.
And look at that. It's perfect. We can adjust it however we want it.
Look, it's dead nuts level.
Both sluice runs will need to be cleaned before the final run.
Get some water through there to get that steel pushed out. Or it's all...
That's all right.
It's gonna be a lot of steel.
Just clean the damn sluice.
You're gonna have micro pieces of steel.
Heavier.
I believe I mentioned he is a little hard-headed. You know, Freddy knows the most. Steve's gonna have to understand that, and I think he's coming to terms with it.
I'll clean it out.
It's the final. Juan has cut the slits and welded in the baffles. The sluice box is fitted, and Freddy delivers one final gift.
Hey, James, you need it?
Absolutely.
All right. Oh, man, look at the size of that thing.
This thing's crazy nice.
Holy crap.
A new pump to go and keep the material running smoothly through both sluice boxes.
Set it down right here for now, I think.
Wow, that thing is just...
Skookum.
I'm jealous.
You're jealous? Why be jealous, buddy? You're part of the show, right?
Nip and Tuck has never had...
Ever. That's crazy. Oh, yeah.
I'll start putting...
Garbage in?
Yep.
This is our new hose here. By putting a second sluice, we're gonna be cutting out some of the water. So what we need to do is add water so it sluices properly. So by putting the second line in, we're gonna be able to do that.
After 5 days, the fixes are complete.
You know, I think the biggest thing that we did here was this actual new sluice system. What we're doing is we're actually giving you a chance to be able to sluice that material.
Now we got a sluice system with the slots that Juan cut in there. It's half inch minus now instead of 2 inch minus.
Yeah.
That's running down this sluice box. So you're half going down here, and you still have your dream available for your big nugget on the end over there.
And that was a big thing. You know, Freddy and I, we talked about it. You know, he didn't want to kill your dream.
I might just have to go bags all over again because I threw so much gold out prior to this.
Basically, what we did is we gave you a whole other circuit.
It's just awesome.
Look inside those rings that Juan cut. You know, it was just sliding out before, right?
On top of that, you'll actually have material build up on the backsides of these.
Yes.
So what that does, gives it a chance to be able to get kicked out.
Could never have imagined such a thing. Goodness, I can't wait to get some gravel through it.
Well,
us too. We're excited about it.
Let's fire it up.
They'll run another 4-hour test to find out if Freddy and Juan are the increase in gold Steve needs to buy his own land and build a home.
I just want to make sure everything's in order, all the pump lines are straight, so on and so forth. They're all distracting.
It's good. So, fire this up.
All right.
Let's do it.
Time to put our money where our mouth is. I want to.
That's it. That's exactly right.
Beast, Steve.
All right, here we go. First scoop in the new system.
You can see it, Freddy. Look at the difference.
No water coming out the end.
That's pretty awesome stuff.
Steve!
Let's see the...
After loading one bucket of pay, Steve has second thoughts.
I'm just gonna crank it up a little bit. The trommel motor, because if I get weight in it, it helps slow it down a little bit, so.
Okay, it's your motor, you runner.
Is he turning it up? I'd almost say turn it down.
It's his baby, though.
Because it's worked well for him.
Yeah.
Something's not right. Oh, what the?
Belt.
Which belt? What's wrong with it?
It's smoking.
At the Nip and Tuck mine, the crucial final test halt.
He's had an issue with his trommel, so. I'm gonna shut the pumps down for now.
The motor just stopped suddenly. We're not sure why.
There wasn't steam coming off of here.
It might have been. I just walked up to it and saw it right away.
Dude, it had oil. It's a brand new motor. I think it's the belt. I think it's the belt just stretching. There's so much weight on it. We'll try it again, see what.
Steve restarts the plant, but dials it back to the original speed.
Water, there's more rocks. It seems like the belt might be stretching out a little bit, the fan belt. We do have a spare, so I'm a little, not on edge, but I'm just ready. All these little tweaks get made. If that trommel's not turning, there's no gold coming out at all.
They've lost 10 minutes, but the run is back on. There is fine gold. It should be dropping through one slits and catching in the new sluice. Bigger nuggets can still come through the 2-inch punch left in Steve's old sluice.
Those sluices are both running extremely well. And we've got those slit cuts for the finer gold and the smaller pieces. Now they don't have to compete with those on that other sluice box. I know we've improved this gold recovery. How much, I don't know, but we'll find out soon.
When Freddy and Juan first arrived, the rocks trommel were covered in mud, holding fine gold.
Check that out, Freddy.
It's a lot cleaner. I mean, a lot. I'm happy with that.
Juan's baffles have slowed the water enough to clean the gold off the rocks.
Freddy, look at that. Are smaller than 2 inches.
Yep.
So everything 2 inches smaller is making it to the sluice run. I'm happy
nice.
With that.
Nice. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
It's awesome.
After.
Hey, Steve. Last bucket. Last one.
They call time on the final run.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, so what do you think? See
this?
Anything in there?
This box is running awesome.
Oh, yeah. Hey, those riffles are doing exactly what they're supposed to.
Yeah.
They're running
beautiful.
Good.
You know that if there's any great big nuggets, they're going to fall right in off the, probably be in the top mat there.
Yeah.
Now you actually have a 35-ounce nugget you've been bragging about.
Dude, I don't know what to say, guys.
It looks good. I'm happy about it. What we need to do is clean it up now and see what we got.
Yeah, let's pull them out.
Natural hammer.
Now we're getting ready to pull the carpets out. See what we got. I mean, you're not seeing much in there, but if a sluice is working properly, you don't want to see it because if it's on, it can get away from you. Hey, Steve, have a look at this.
What do you got there?
Now, this is one pan.
Just one pan.
No kidding.
And look at all that binding.
Oh my goodness sakes. Oh my goodness sakes. Look at that.
Easy.
Whoa.
Spill it.
All the fine gold. It's really what you want to look at.
Yeah, look at it. Oh, man, oh, man. Look at that. Nice, nice. Little tiny, tiny, tiny little bits.
That's pretty good.
Absolutely.
Lots of real small stuff. I'm excited now, Wano.
Looks good. Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
After 5 days, it's time to find out if Freddy and Juan's fixes have worked.
Well, guys.
Moment of truth, huh?
Dime for the weigh-in.
The first test run weighed 0.13 of an ounce. Freddie and Juan promise of at least 15%, which means this gold weigh needs to be around 0.15 of an ounce.
Here it is.
Okay.
Look at that,
0.22.
Nice.
That's awesome. Proud of that's awesome.
Wow, I cannot believe that, guys.
And look at all the fine gold in there, too. Damn.
There is fine gold
when
here.
When we were talking, 15% is what we would do.
Oh, you're
that's quite
more
a bit more than
15%.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's way more.
A massive increase of 70%.
I knew I was never knew it was that much. Oh, my goodness sakes, what a difference this is going to make.
The changes we've done this week, you know, hopefully that puts you on a path where you can buy that piece of property and build.
In a full day's running, with Freddy and Juan's 70% increase, Steve should now mine around $1,000. That's every 2 days. If the weather holds, it'll be enough to get the 21 ounces he needs to build his dream property.
It's time this season. It's a tough hill to climb, but weather forecast is nice for the month of October, so.
Well, there's only one way to do it, right?
And that's wash, run. Time in the machine.
Run.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, gentlemen. Stay in touch, okay?
Absolutely.
There, James.
Safe travel.
You know, we kept him 15%. We did a little better than that. I'm proud of this, Freddy. Another good one.
I'm proud, bud.
Let's get on the road.
Let's do it.
The Con Expo Equipment Show, Las Vegas.
Congratulations last year, man.
Thanks.
You won a hell of a lot of gold.
I heard you're...
I'm going to make another run of 5,000. And according to... math Freddy's running thinks he can do it.
According to the math that you guys have told me over the last 7 years, you
it's the best ground we've
that's
ever
what
done.
You said last year. What do you mean?
You challenged me for 5,000?
Seriously? You told me last year you were gonna beat Tony and I combined. How'd that work out? What are we wagering?
100 ounces?
$1,000.
You win? You do that?
Yeah, sure.
See you later.
Good luck.
Every time that I've crashed in my... You know what? That kid is arrogant. I'm going to take him down this year.
He's putting his money where his mouth is, so I'm pretty surprised to see that. But...
And right here, this is ours. We got our best pay dirt that we've ever seen right here in Colorado. And I think we can pull it. We got the big guns coming in. I got Monster Red. I've got 3 wash plants, 2 claims for high water. I'm going to beat that kid, Parker.
You know, if it was just about beating Todd this summer, it'd be easy. But he isn't my only battle. We're on 2 fronts. For 4 seasons, I've had to answer to Tony Beats. He's taken $2.5 million. Now, I've got a plan to buy my freedom. A deal on...
This year, failure is not an option. We're going to do 3,000 ounces, and I'm going to take the dress out of this. So we're running this fall in Eureka Creek. The last thing standing in my way is this ice in the river. The minute that breaks, there's no ifs or buts about it. It's going to have to happen. Nothing is going to stop me now.
Thank you. Klondike. Parker Schnabel assembles his crew for the first time this season at his Indian...
How you guys doing?
Good, man.
So I'd like to just thank you. Really looking forward to the summer. Mitch, last year you were basically our only mechanic. And so I'd like to welcome Mike back. Thanks for coming back.
Be back working with you guys, you know.
That's good. This winter I ran into Todd Hoffman in Vegas. And of course he was running his mouth about how he always does every spring. He ended up betting us 100 ounces of gold that he'd beat us.
And you took that bet.
Of course.
He gets at least 100 ounces so he can pay us that.
You can't underestimate him too much because you never know where the gold is, right? If you sluice enough dirt like he does, eventually you will find a pile of gold. Todd thinks he's going to get 5,000 ounces. I don't think here's how getting 5,000 ounces this summer. Rick, that's going to mean at least 2,500 ounces out of Big Red.
That's twice what we did last year.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want Todd's sluice
turn on and never shut off. Otherwise, there's no way it's going to happen.
We'll need that head start.
Then we should just set up shop down here until we're sluicing.
I agree.
Todd shit.
It's going to be a bloodbath.
It is. I wouldn't want to go to battle with any other group of people.
It's a good group.
Yeah.
Not a good raid.
Let's go to war, boys.
Yeah.
Biggest he's never, and it's just some extra pressure added on top of that bet with Todd, you know? I'm kind of, just because you never know. You never know where the gold is. I am not giving Todd Hoffman 100 ounces of my gold. So, kick his ass.
Coming up, Dad!
2,000 miles south, at his Sacramento mine in Colorado, Todd Hoffman and crew are together and start sluicing.
I think we got to jump on Parker. We got the big guns. We got here early. Hey, Freddy. Come on in, Kev. Okay. You see the snow falling? It's going to be falling like this when we leave. We got 5 to 6 months. See if we can get 5,000 ounces in one season.
You know what it's like to fake it? We're setting the same goal, man. We can't fail again.
Last season, Todd's was shattered in Oregon.
3.55 ounces.
That's it.
That's it.
And his crew went into milk.
Next 2 weeks without pay.
You tell Mindy I'm not getting paid.
Hey!
No.
A lot of things happened last year. It's here getting 5,000 ounces. I believe it enough. I got 100 ounces on it with Parker.
How much?
100 ounces.
That's like
he shook on it. You know what? Here's why we're going to get 5,000. We're going to be running 3 plants. Rusty Red, then we got Monster Frickin' Red. You've never ran 3 plants before. No one has. Guys, we got to really leave it. You know?
I know we can't go through what we did last year, but I do believe that the ground is good.
I got 100 grand, and I don't want to hand that kid anything. Nothing. Let's go beat him.
Yeah!
All right, miss.
5,000 ounces is crazy. You know, it's not just Todd's journey. It's all of our journey. And Todd doesn't do good. It hurts.
Before Todd and his crew can get any gold in the box, they must finish a semester red.
Let's go. We've got some conveyors.
Hey, Dad.
What?
Last year you let me feed. Double trouble. That's through it.
What are you getting at?
Well, I was wondering if I could run Monster Red this year.
Just
no, I
want
to run the whole plant.
You want to run the whole
10 years old. I've went mining with you every single summer.
Hunter has been by his father's side since Todd's first gold.
We just kind of sit here and watch him move mud. Yeah, that's a piece of gold.
How many guys I've seen that has the finesse and the controls that Hunter has, he's just a natural.
I know I have a lot to learn, maybe, but I think I can do it.
We don't get to 5,000. It could be your fault. Are you willing to take goals and come off that plant? You know that.
I know. I know it's not going to be easy, and I want you to give me a shot.
How about 2 weeks? I'll let you start out, run the plant for 2 weeks. If you do good, you can have it for the rest of the season. If you don't, I gotta pull you off. Play favorites with you, okay?
Fine, okay, 2 weeks, we have a deal?
You got a deal.
But I get to run it my way.
Okay.
Hunter's first job in charge of Monster Red? Fit the 12,000-pound conveyor to the wash plant.
Dad.
Put the tailings conveyor on, just see what it looks like.
Well, you can do it however you want, but...
Okay, let's take that one. Hook me up.
How he wants it to go down.
Center.
Right a bit.
That's the heavy end.
Right here.
Boom out. He's got to stick out.
One.
Really? He does. Everything he picks.
Hunter is on the ground trying to tell his dad, you know, what we need to do, and... I'll talk to him.
Whoa! Hey, guys, get out of the way.
Yeah, no.
It's really gonna be kippy.
You're gonna have to bring your...
Okay.
Hey, what's this? Not this.
I'm trying to tell you, you're not gonna fit.
You mean I'm not here, don't I?
You're gonna hit it.
Dad! Hitting me!
He's got his. This is the feet conveyor. It doesn't even have the.
Is that not even the right conveyor?
No.
This is the wrong conveyor for this.
What?
Guess what? This is the wrong conveyor.
They're both the same.
18-year-old Hunter's first task running Monster Red is to finish building it. But Todd is finding it hard to hand over power.
Like you're a genius. Like, this is a great plan. It's not going together good.
You're 18 years old. You know how many times I put this conveyor together? A lot. Identical.
The other one has way more impact rollers down at the bottom.
Well, we can unbolt them and take them off.
Are you me?
It's to rebuild the conveyor.
Todd wants this conveyor, so we're gonna go ahead and do it. He's the boss, so that's what he wants, that's what we're gonna do. You know, this is the start of the season, and if this is any kind of glimpse of what it's gonna be like, it's gonna be real difficult.
You might be good at eating burgers, but you're not good at putting wash plants together, okay? You're gonna put me in charge of this plant, we made a deal, and I think it should be, and you weren't listening to a single thing I said today.
You know what, dude? You could be putting us a day behind running.
Me?
Yeah.
You're putting us a day behind running because do you want to change them? It's hard to change them.
Shut up and let me talk, okay? I did put you in charge, and I will switch out the conveyor. If that okay?
That's what I want to do. That's what okay. I wanted to do earlier. If I'm in charge, then I want to put Andy in there because I know we have trouble working.
You want me off? Fine. But if we don't get set up quick and we don't get the gold, you're off this plant. For just a quick minute... He actually reminded me of me. And I don't know if that's good or bad. It's always hard to son, and you know what? You know what? Maybe it's time. I'm getting fat and old and ass, I guess.
It's hard telling my dad that, but I just need to get this plant going, so that's all it is.
Let's go.
Hunter brings in lead operator Andy Spinks to lift in the right conveyor for the tailings.
Exactly.
Watch yourself over there.
Oh, hey, hey,
here we go, Andy. Swing like a...
Looks good so far.
Up, up.
Chain on the excavators Buckley gains back control and places the conveyor next to Monster Red.
Are you okay over there, Thurber?
Yep.
Pretty skip. The chain still held it, and everybody's okay, so.
We got the right conveyor in the right place. Now we just have to get it up on the sand.
Once the crew sets the conveyor, Monster Red will be ready to sluice. Hunter has completed his first challenge without...
You need a break from your dad.
Yeah, I know he's just... He's excited and wants to get this done, and he doesn't want to, I don't know, take it. I don't know.
It doesn't get any better, man. My dad's 64 years old, and he still does the same thing to me, too. So just deal with it. Just need some, you know, some time apart and do your own thing. But we did good. Yep. Let's get some bolts.
North, in the Klondike, Parker's crew, 24 hours away from starting up their wash plant, Big Red.
We're running low yardage. I don't think we'll be able to play catch up. So we're doing everything we can to make sure Big Red's ready to run.
Unlike Todd, Parker's ounces relies on just two wash plants. In the creek cut, Slucifer will run 282 miles downstream at Indian River. Big Red runs less than half the dirt, so the crew needs to get it running. All they have to do is move it nearer to the cut.
We're gonna move Big Red 400 feet that way, closer to the cut. Bingo bango. We'll be sluicing tomorrow. And now it's time for me to get busy. Nobody walks on Gold Rush. Should we carefully yank this thing out of the dirt?
Everything's disconnected. You're pretty much ready to go.
Awesome. It's a good day. Well, I'm not on the Hoffman claim. I don't know. I'd bet money we're going to beat him.
You're set, Rick. Let's let it rip.
Ground.
We try ripping through the ice, we can't break it.
We're gonna have to dig it out or something.
Dig it out more! There you go, down!
I don't like sitting and waiting to try to dig this thing out, but I really don't want to damage it.
To avoid breaking the plant, the crew digs a trench to get to the frozen ground beneath Big Red.
Is it frozen in there? Yeah, it is. Well, this don't help. Can't even get it to budge. What a pain in the ass.
Yes, sir. We want to beat the Hoffmans to it. If we break something on Big Red, if we don't have the parts here, and we could be waiting a few days to get it up and running, we don't want that.
Machines every year, and it always ends up coming back to a guy in a shovel.
Get that front end washed out.
Let's do it. Starting to take time I don't have.
Either man, because yeah. I don't know what it's going to do.
Yeah.
Tyson's going to give it a push. What we don't want to do here is just fold these in the center like a big taco shell. Let's see what you got, Rick. Come on, baby. Nice and easy, Tyson.
Go up with it a bit. Am I pulling this thing any harder?
Keep bouncing it. It's falling in the back.
30 tons and running 750 horsepower can't free Big Red from the ice. Every day they don't sluice, head start.
I don't know if you can dig that out, honestly. Plant's frozen.
Into a desperate battle to free their ice-bound wash plant. Big Red
froze up
for Todd Hoffman.
Every hour this takes is potentially another hour head start that Todd Hoffman gets, right?
Keep my bars. Nothing that'll do any damage.
No, not through that. That's like concrete in there.
Man, I can barely scratch this stuff. This is like it's been here for a million years.
Is there anything else we can do? Do you let it thaw? No, we don't have time for that, right?
They're both right there.
The last resort, two propane flame.
Water power, fire power. I guarantee the Hoffmans aren't dealing with the in Colorado. They're probably just worried about what's for dinner.
Try to get that frozen in pretty good.
Let me get more yank on it.
I'm just worried about twisting things.
Yeah.
You're clear now.
Go ahead, Rick.
Alrighty.
In the frozen dirt.
That was two.
Big Red.
You, Frost.
Giver.
Rick drags the wash plant 400 feet down the cut.
Can you give me just a little more lift? There you go, now walk with it.
A full day lost, but one step closer to sluicing.
Right here, we're fine, Rick.
That's how you...
No, we just got to put it together, get it going.
Good job, guys. First battle down, but it's a long war.
This battle with the Hoffmans, it's going to be like kicking a puppy.
No one kicks our puppy.
Lately, and I like the proof that that dredge is more efficient than everything else.
Tony beats... is back in the Klondike.
The dredge was a failure. I don't like that feeling. I don't like to come up short. But you know what? Don't give up. Just get at it a bit harder next time.
Owns the only working dredge in the Klondike.
Let's get some gold in the box.
Last year, he bought a second for $1 million
project
and spent all season building a barge with his foreman, Gene Cheeseman, to transport it 100 miles downriver. But he failed to get the permit he needed to move the dredge.
Well, that just nicely me.
Hey, guys.
Hello.
Hi, guys.
What's up?
You're back.
Now, he's called his family together to set their mission.
Please get the dredge out of Thistle Creek and get that thing running this year. The good news is the land use permit is in place. We got the boats. We got everything. Just need the bad news is we will not have a Gene this year.
Why not?
Well, Gene had other things to do. Comply with, I guess.
So, what are you going to do now? Do you have a plan B?
There's only one guy that can replace Gene in the Klondike. Have a chat, see what he thinks. If you get the right guy, then the chance of being successful is the way out there. Right?
To move Dredge 2, Tony's placing all his bets on a man who already has a day job. Local mining...
So, Tony, exactly how far out is it located from town, this dredge?
Well, it'll be 100 miles upriver.
100 miles. I'm going to have a look. I'm not committing to anything.
There it is, Todd. Fort Knox.
Seamus, fabricator behind the 75-ton wash plant, Fort Knox.
I personally think this is the best wash plant in the Klondike.
And he's helped Klondike miners move massive equipment for years.
Ooh.
But even for Seamus, a 500-ton dredge is a first.
Go have a look. Well, that's it, Seamus.
Jeez, she's a monster.
Was built in 1946 and is 150 tons heavier than dredge number one. It mined for Vanden at Thistle Creek.
That's one hell of a piece of shit, isn't it?
Looks like more than one truckload, that's for sure.
Yeah, no kidding.
I'll follow you.
The shape it is in is second to none. You can buy a new one tomorrow, and I wouldn't be any better without a shaft. I like this dredge 10 times better than... Wouldn't even have to buy a new belt. It's pristine as it comes. I mean, it's without a question. The thing to figure out is, apart and what don't we have to take apart? What can we get away with, right?
You're saying we? I mean you.
I mean, I think you're the right man for it, because there's no capable of doing a project like that.
I know I'm capable of the job, but I have a lot of other responsibilities and my own thing going on. I mean, I've been mining like you.
Hey, it'll show you something you like. That's quite a girl, huh?
The dredge's cult was built to power army tugboats.
I think there's no reason why this wouldn't run. But I mean, have a look at this.
Whiskey in there.
No.
It was brand new in there. We don't make engines like this at all anymore. It's pretty rare. That would be really neat to see that running.
I'd love to see this one. I think it'd be pretty darn cool. You being a mechanic by trade, right?
I remember seeing dredge number one, your dredge number one, running back in the 80s.
Really? A couple days back.
I didn't think I'd ever see another one running in the Yukon. Technology's changed. A lot of people didn't believe in the dredges.
No, but I mean, that I'm not a bit scared of the project at all. All I can say is you're in or you're out.
I'm in.
Let's do it. Let's make this work, right?
A long time, he's always been a crazy guy. Has crazy ideas, but so do most miners. It's the only way you survive. In some sick way, I'm kind of looking forward to it.
This is the point of picking the right people. And without a question, that Seamus can do it.
Can't keep mining under Tony.
The ground would include about 175 claims.
Just maybe picking a big old bag.
Quiet for a while.
Lease.
What the f*** are you doing?
Neighbors pretty soon.
No f***
what?
Big Red for the first time this season.
At his Indian River claim, Parker and ready to sluice. Just one day behind schedule.
You want to send some water up here and make it?
Fire it up, buddy.
Yeah, we got water, bud. Want to get these conveyors spinning?
We're ready for them?
Yeah. Everybody clear!
Red is ready for the first dirt of the season.
Woo! Hey, Tyson, let's go! Fuck it.
Fox rattling against steel. Who the fuck can make it feel so good? I see any weird spray coming out of it. Oh yeah, water to deck.
The shaker deck should be bouncing on its springs.
You never turn it on.
We got the other one.
Yeah.
We're rusty.
Is that a long? We got the shaker deck shaking. And it looks like it never shut off.
It's the earliest we've ever been going, I think.
To hit 5,000 ounces. The crew needs to keep sluicing 5 months.
Now we're gonna run the piss out of it till it breaks.
Yeah!
Killing it!
But they have no idea if they've...
Hey, Parker! I'm gonna call Todd and give him the good news.
Come on. Freddy Dodge. Hey, man, it's Rick now. Hey, is Todd with you? He's not gonna take the call?
Todd won't take the call.
Dude, he's not gonna take the call. Well, I'll tell you what, man. I know that Rick and Parker are sluicing at Indian River. We did it, man. We're sluicing first.
All right. Ask if the bet's still on.
Going down, Hoffman.
Hoffman's are in catch-up mode.
Well, I got a text. Old Parker's running already, so... You know, I can look at that, or I can look at it like, you know what, I'm putting my war machine together and we're going to kick his ass.
Todd's plan to hit 5,000 ounces and 3 wash plants. Freddy will operate Rusty Red at the Fairplay claim. Half a mile west at Sacral Charge of Double Trouble. And Hunter will run their ace in the hole, Monster Red.
You know, are really crazy, but this year, I'm the most positive I've ever been. We know what kind of gold's here. We're bringing in 3 wash plants, and I think we're going
to... To fire up Monster Red is water. For the last 24 hours, the crew has been filling Monster Red's holding...
Ease. Oh. Yeah. Why is that not filling up?
I think we're losing out the whole bottom.
The hell is it
going? We just need to... We need to fix it.
Kevin, turn that water off.
Okay.
The porous base of the pond. Water to drain into the dirt. Until the Hoffmans fix the problem, they're losing valuable sluicing time.
It's costing us money every boat.
I think we're gonna have to slap a liner in it.
you know, it's another 20,000-30,000 bucks to line that.
Putting a liner in, that's going to take another week, and Parker's already sluicing.
Well, at this point, we just got to make a choice what we're going to do.
We already have doubled water. It's full of silt. Why don't we dig a trench between Double Trouble's pond and ours, below the dam, wash some of the silt down into our pond. I think it'll seal it.
Hunter's solution? Dig a channel from Monster Red's empty pond to Double Trouble's full pond. Flow down the channel. As it settles, the silt should create a natural watertight liner, sealing the pond.
Liner in it is a surefire bet. The thing I'm most worried about is we blow all that silt in there and we don't fix the leak. We've got a pool full of silt and no water.
You said you want to run Monster Red. You're 2 weeks started, and you got a serious decision to make.
This is going to affect the entire season.
I think we should try it.
All right.
Sounds like a plan.
Andy, grab 700. All right, let's go.
Until hunters test both Double Trouble and Monster Red are out of action, losing the Hoffmans up to $60,000 in gold.
First big decisions of running this operation, and the stuff my dad's always had it done, so I don't know. A lot of pressure on me right now.
Hunter, you got a copy, Hunter?
Copy.
What do you think, buddy?
It's getting pretty close.
Sure.
In Colorado, 18-year-old Hunter Hoffman has made his first major call. Seal holding pond with a layer of silt from Double Trouble's neighboring pond.
And he's going to dig a trench, and we blow this out, seals our pond too, so that's the plan.
But if it doesn't work, the Hoffmans will have to delay sluicing while they line the pond with Pine Parker, and losing them hundreds of thousands of dollars in gold.
We're getting close. I got about another 10 feet. The water will start. These decisions are lonely. You don't know if it's right or wrong. You're either a hero or a goat. And I don't know how this one's going to go. I really don't. There's some water coming through. Water's trickling through.
Yeah, you can see it at the bottom.
Yeah, 10-4. It is dangerous. Hunter, stay back. What are we seeing? I think it's going to break through. Get a big bullet. Pull it.
Go, get some.
There she goes. Oh, yeah. There.
Shut that off. We'll start filling up both ponds and get sluicing.
We got it.
Hunter's gamble has paid off. The silt has sealed the leak, is holding water.
Parker better watch out, because they're about to get running.
Big Red has been running for 3 straight days. Operator Spider feeds the plant with pay dirt.
We're running pretty fast. We're doing 130, 140 yards an hour, and hopefully we're on the gold.
In the cut, Parker loads pay dirt into the rock truck.
The first time that Todd and I met 8 years ago, what was I, 15?
He's been mining since he was 6 years old. He's got a lot more experience.
They're amateurs when they dig through with their fingers. Don't know what they're doing. It's just gold fever. That's all it is.
Todd's world. And now we've beat him 4 years running. This will be number 5. I'm not bragging or anything. I'm just...
What the f***? Ledge is on fire. Parker's coming real fast. It's on fire? Are you kidding me?
Fire.
Is that full?
Yes.
Here. It's burning. Watch yourself. Here.
Yeah.
shot, man. I think it's out.
That's not good.
I don't think anything in there is salvageable.
If I just let it cool down, because dumping all that, we might crack something.
I think the oxygen's out of my lungs, too.
We always joke about running them till they burn to the ground, but we're always just joking. Mine, it's right behind the turbo. Oil sprayed out and got on the hot exhaust and got in flames.
Did somebody hit the bypass?
Yeah.
Or the wash plant is shut down. Parker's losing $2,600 worth of gold.
Let's just grab another loader.
Okay.
Parker's other loader is 2 miles north on the other side of the claim.
That's a real pain in the ass that that's what takes us down.
We can't afford any breakdowns.
It's going to hold us up quite a bit. What the f***? What the hell? What is this?
The river going through where the road's supposed to be.
Heavy overnight rain has washed out.
We're pretty well screwed.
The only way to reach the loader is to rebuild it.
And our exit, of course. Well, one of us is getting wet.
Rock, paper, scissors?
Sir? I've got a life ring right back here if you need it.
Perfect.
My rock, paper, scissors skills are good.
That sucked. Is that cold? If he had his phone out of his pocket. I'm just gonna have to throw a bunch of rock back in here and try to put this road back in as quick as to getting gold.
Seepage coming through this. It's gonna be all right. Lucky my lighter didn't get wet.
Pants are falling down. It's just so wet and heavy. You okay?
No.
The road's crossable. I mean,
deal with it when we get a loader fixed.
A small hiccup, right? In the big scheme of things, life is good.
After 6 hours and nearly $16,000 in lost gold.
Big. We lost probably a shift, but we got another loader down here. The main thing is we're back running, and that's all that counts.
Kick ass.
2 days after Parker fired up Big Red, all three of their wash plants, Rusty Red, Double Trouble, and Monster Red, finally ready to
sponge. But make no mistake, guys, we're going to war this summer. Those guys up north, they have no idea what's coming at them. Announces. Freddy, you ready?
Rusty Red's ready to make gold, Todd.
All right. Hunter, you got Monster Red?
It's ready to go.
I'll be down at the C team. It might have won the battle. He's got Big Red and he's running. But we're gonna win the war. Let's get fired up. These guys will take some freaking gold home to their families. As a leader, I gotta step up. Last year I failed, and this year I'm gonna do.
Once all three wash plants are sluicing, Todd will be running an unprecedented 800 yards of pay dirt an hour. On Big Red, first to fire up is 50-year-old Double Trouble.
There it is, Dad. Double Trouble. New route. Heading towards 5,000 ounces.
We'll get it.
All right. I'll tell you what, Juan, she ain't the prettiest girl at the dance, but she's got lots of moves.
You know, this is an exciting moment. We've never had three plants before. This year, we're going to have three. We're going to get some gold.
Hey, guys, I'm going to go ahead and fire up Double Trouble.
All right.
Sounds good.
Number two. We're coming online with the conveyor for the... Okay, seatbelt on. All right, Todd, ready to go.
She spoke a lot. So did John, Wayne. Hunter.
Fire that monster rack.
Let's run some dirt.
Hey, Hunter, gonna fire up the screen. Hey, each conveyor's on.
I'm about to... You know, I've never had this kind of responsibility, you know, running this whole feeling. It just makes all the hard work worth it right here.
Two down. One to go.
Freddy, fire up Rusty Rack. Freddy, what are you...
I need to talk to you. We got a big problem at Fairplay.
What's up, dude?
We're in deep trouble at Fairplay.
What do you mean? Something broke?
They got our water shut down. Basically, we got served an injunction by the state. We can't use those ponds. We have no water right now.
Why?
They're saying they're off the active mining shutoffs.
The Division of Reclamation, Mining, and Safety has deemed the water supply to Freddy's wash plant illegal. Drain his two ponds immediately.
Are you kidding?
No. No, I'm shut down. I have no water.
If Freddy can't operate Rusty Red, the Hoffmans won't be able to run the dirt they of 5,000 ounces and beat Parker.
I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what the hell's going on. I mean, we were served an injunction. I can't pour it and fight it. I don't know. It's just not a good day.
Dawson City. Residents gather top of the world highway. Becomes a river once again. With them is Tony Beats.
The ice is breaking up. Been waiting for this all winter. So now it's awesome. My boat's ready. I got chambers to take the rest of my season.
The ice was Tony's last obstacle. Now he can get his power barge Jasmine Pecan River and start moving his second dredge.
So we got the Oshkosh running here. Jasmine B sipped on the draft.
Well, let's see if we can get it in the center a little bit more. It'd be nice to get another 10 feet over.
Yeah, I'll pull myself away from the bank.
You get in there, we'll take the blocks out, okay?
Mike Beats must pull the barge up the steep bank into a better position.
Rock them.
To handle Tony's 60-ton mega barge?
That's it. Keep it on.
Mike's 8-wheel drive, Oshkosh. Seamus Christie's family mine for gold in Scroggy Creek, one valley over from Thistle Creek. Every spring, even their cabin, 100 miles along the frozen Yukon River, using a dozer to carve out a road. A 60-ton power barge, the Jasmine B, has slipped off its trailer. Without it, he'll never bring his million-dollar dredge.
We really need to get this in the water. We have well over 30 trips to make with this barge. It's a 3-day round trip, and every day we lose, we can't make up.
Well, we're going to have to bring it this way, Mike. We'll throw the wind line in there, pull it back off.
Tony's plan? Loader with forks up front, while Monica pulls in a second loader from the other side.
Now all we got to do is pull it back up. Back it up. Boost, Monica, pull. Pull. Step on that thing. Pull. Monica, give her. Mike, punch her. Pull. Use your fucking stick. Pull.
Mike takes another shot at getting the power barge safely into the river.
Let's put it in the water, guys. Okay, Mike, back the...
preparation, Tony is ready to start the 100-mile journey upriver to his dredge at Thistle Creek.
We're ready to go.
I'm in California meeting a couple guys that have ground up in the Yukon.
Parker has flown to Springs, California, in search of a deal that could change his future.
I just can't keep mining under Tony, and I've got royalty rates are so outrageous. I'm willing to take a big gamble on anything that doesn't have these same terms.
Parker takes up to 30% of all the gold he mines.
Right now, we give him a huge amount of royalty payments, and I can't imagine.
Hey, Parker, how are you? Good to see you. Come on in.
Thanks. Pat Lau and his wife, Joan, own land in the Klondike, together with local miner Stuart Schmidt.
So, Parker, what
find out a little more about that ground you've got in the Indian River.
And what are you interested in doing with it? We've discussed it between ourselves. We probably look at some.
Yeah, do you have a map?
Okay. So here's that we're talking about would include about 135 claims.
Wow.
Something like that.
Holy cow. It's a lifetime of mining here.
There is. Well, this is Tony's ground, right?
Dredge is set up just right in here somewhere. Huh?
Right.
Right. Holy. Here. So this is literally right next to Tony's dredge.
Like 500 feet away?
He could. But like Tony being right there does create a bit of an issue.
Right.
But that's my problem, not your guys's.
Yeah.
I'm thrilled. Been looking for something like this for several years. You know, it depends on what kind of royalty rate, I guess, you guys.
We were thinking of the standard 10%.
Yeah. Wow.
So we get 600.
Is that standard? Because right now, if I do 6,000 ounces, I would pay double that. Because it's 30% royalty over.
No.
Wow.
You're kidding. That's a lot. That's unacceptable, really, to pay that kind of royalty. You're dealing with different people.
We shouldn't talk about it too much. Wow. I really do want to move forward with this.
Well, then we should just move forward, okay? So,
to
you too?
Yes, I'm all forward.
Okay, do it. 10% royalty. Yeah. Wow. Only 2 pages? Where's the other 15 pages?
Pretty basic.
Lists.
Yeah, should probably keep it quiet for a while.
That makes this very interesting.
Mm-hmm. It'll be fun.
Well,
we can't stop. Drive safely.
Thanks, Ken.
Bye.
Parker's first land deal away from Tony Beats has bought him a future on low royalty.
That's a result. Except for staking ground, it doesn't get better than that. I mean, you know how he acts when it comes to not being able to keep a tight leash on me. So, we'll see.
Later, Parker is back in the Klondike with a new land deal under his belt. Creek and his current landlord, Tony Beats, just yet.
I like mining. I like being up here. And the more places we, the better chance we'll have of being able to make a success out of it for a long time. But for the time being, Tony Beats is going to be our home base because I've got a big investment.
Gold mining is a long-term operation. At Scribner Creek, Parker's already spent $1 million in rip through permafrost, strip overburden, and open cuts to get to gold-rich pay dirt. Gets the gold out of the ground. He can't afford to escape Tony. And right now, Parker's current lease.
I can't have Tony Beats find out about this new land with Ken and Stewart and go crazy and try to kick us off the ground. Ow. My main concern now is the Yukon's a pretty small place. He may already know, and it could just be a big grenade, right? You know where Tony's at?
He just went down in the yard.
All right, thanks. How are you doing?
Okay, what's happening?
Okay, let's do it. All right. I don't know why this thing's so many pages, Tony.
I have no I didn't write it down there. You got any goals?
Well, I don't know if you've heard about this whole bet with Todd.
A little bit, yeah.
So he's saying 5 like that.
Well, that's quite a goal, huh? That's $1,500,000 royalties, so that adds up to, huh?
Happy to sign this?
Yeah, I'll sign this.
Sweet.
There is no argument on this paperwork. I'll piss them off some other day. How's that, Parker?
We'll piss each other off, I'm sure.
Going. Good deal, my man. Have a good one.
Left have coffee.
Yeah.
Again, we'll do sometime soon.
All right.
You too.
Go get me some gold, but yeah.
Working on it.
Thank you, sir.
Parker's contract saved Grivner Creek.
Got her done.
Now he can mine Tony's ground at the same time as starting work on his new low royalty.
Go with Tony. We've got a lease signed, and we can go down there and start stripping this new ground that we got from Kenneth Stewart. He definitely may not like it.
I like Parker. I like the ambition of the bet. That's why we took him on. So now he's doing about 5,000 ounces. Good for him, good for us. But it's not a business, two completely different things. Anyway, I'm glad that contract bull is over with. I really have better to do. Get this thing loaded. Get it out of here.
After a whole season of delays, Tony Beats and his foreman, Seamus Christie, are finally setting out.
We need to get started on taking this dredge apart.
Tony's new captain, Rick Bloom, will pilot this river.
Ready to set sail, I think. Crank the up. Put it down the...
Tony's mega barge leaves Dawson and starts a 100-man river to Thistle Creek, where his 500-ton second dredge has lain idle for over 60 years.
It may take 14, 16 hours, but we were overnight to get some rest halfway up.
Maybe 10 months late, but you know what? This time, I'm going to let people stop us. On the water. Feels good. Let's get the over to Thistle Creek. Get them dreads out of there. We got a loader on there now. It doesn't seem to be anything. We'll just put two on.
The 50-ton crane will be the next load.
Yeah. Well, we're going to need it up there. Then you really can move some crap. Bingo.
Harry!
What the was that?
What's going on?
What do you got?
Starboard engine's overheating.
Whoa, she's really hot.
I'll get it and go have a look.
What the thing?
Tony and Seamus head below deck to check on the engine.
Wow, that's hot.
So what the thing was that?
Something in the cooling system for the engine. There's cold water coming in, but the engine is smoking hot.
Well, it is bull. I guess not my choice. Let's turn the water and we're gonna pull, right?
Tony can't risk engine failure on the river. He has no option.
Bingo, next disaster. Seems to be never ending.
Miles south, Parker Schnabel is on Tony's home turf on a mission to prospect.
The only road access to this ground of Kenneth Stewart is right through Tony's camp. But, you know, Tony's the kind of guy that likes to fight him, so hopefully he's not around. It looks pretty quiet around here.
Land begins less than half a mile beyond Tony's camp.
Oh, I'm just gonna dig a hole. Pretty as good a spot as any.
The results of this test hole will decide his mining plan and how long Parker continues as Tony.
We got gravel. That's a good sign. tries to just pick a spot like this and come up with gravel right there, so. Well, I've got a scoop of hay, so we'll grab a pan and see what happens. This is good. See, it's nice blocky stuff and just covered in nice sand and garnets and all sorts of stuff in there. I'm hopeful to find any gold at this point. I would see just a couple, really.
We shall bushwhack.
How many? One, two. I can't count that high. Oh, that's a 20 or 30 flake pan.
That's impressive.
For what we'd for digging a hole out of the ground, sloppy wet, that's pretty damn surprising. I don't get pans like
gold in the ground. Now Parker must decide how many men and machines he wants to transfer here. Oh.
I'd be pretty interested to get in here with more equipment, because thawed ground with pans like that.
What the f*** are you doing? You kind of lost or something?
Well, now's as good a time as ever.
What the f***?
Well, I'm on a lease with Ken and Stewart on the ground.
No f- what?
I'm done jumping through f- hoops.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's all right.
And that's all you do is you move the hoops around and make mm-hmm. me dive through them.
Well,
you. I'm just trying to have a good long-term place, mm-hmm. which you've always made pretty difficult.
No.
And a lease that doesn't have a bunch of, and that's really what it is. Is
I want to make it easy on you.
I don't know.
I'm going to get you water. Across the other property.
Your ground?
Yeah. There you go.
So, you're not gonna make this easy.
I don't know if I can stop you or not, but I can sure make things difficult. I'm gonna count on and I'm gonna be on your case, quite simple. Parker, you have yourself a good day.
Whatever, Tony.
Todd's third wash plant, Rusty Red, has been sitting idle for a week, leaving it to wash plants double trouble and mud.
We ran a lot of yards, we have two plants running, and we're doing our first cleanup.
It'd be nice to see something, even a piece. No way.
Dude, come here. Seriously, come and look at this. Look at that. I don't even remember getting pieces like that last year.
Third gold of the season, but the Hoffmans won't know if they've beaten Parker until tomorrow's gold way.
My dad, I know he's really stressed out right now. Really good for my dad and the whole team.
You guys got some gold for this thing?
Hell yeah.
That's drying out right now.
At Scribner, gold of the season is in the pan.
I'm glad that we were able to get going as quick as we were. I know it didn't come without its problems, but yep. Let's get some gold on the scale.
Time the Hoffmans has paid off.
Here we go.
Holy
how's that, Rick?
To be on track for their $5 million goal, Parker needs at least 200 ounces.
40, look at that, Sean. 70, 90, 130, 150. 170, 180, 296, 197, 198.
Oh, it's over.
Oh, 200. How about 201.9?
Oh, man. Dude, that's awesome.
Awesome. Well done, Mitch.
Seriously, that boy is.
That's what we're shooting for, right?
That should put us ahead of.
Yeah.
Keep her up.
Will do.
202 ounces. Is worth $240,000.
Oh, 202 ounces, that's a hell of a result for a first cleanup. If we can keep that up, the season will be a breeze.
In Colorado, air cleanup results.
Let's go look.
It's a lot of gold.
The number to beat? Parker's 202 ounces.
Total.
Together we got 212.05.
212 ounces is $1.
There you go, buddy.
Good job, Hunter.
Yeah. Come on, I know you don't like being hugged by your dad, but this is gonna happen. Let us yours, Hunter. Okay?
Thanks, Dad.
Treat the guys good.
Hunter has earned the right to run Monster Red.
Two or ever.
Just wait till we get Rusty Red in the mix.
We gotta get Freddy off the bench and end the game.
It's ready to go. All I need is water.
I'm gonna take that. Hunter's gonna feel good. Real good. Hey, Parker, this is Todd. How's it going?
You doing?
So what'd you get?
Yeah, we just did our first cleanup, actually. It was 202 ounces.
202?
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what.
We got 212. It's the best start we've ever had.
You're 100 ounces, kid.
Well, I'm...
Obviously, he is bringing his A game this time of the year. I don't think they've ever had 200 ounces or 210 or whatever they've got, but...
This could be Todd's year.
Ahead on the all-new season of Gold Rush.
Todd beat us here.
Might be our best season ever.
Between Lucifer and Big Red, we've got two very hungry mouths to feed.
Parker
Hoffman. The guy couldn't find gold in a jewelry store.
If the fire makes that red, we got to evacuate.
Doubles down with two 75-year-old dredges.
Look out!
The thing is going to go.
Do you have to make space for gold from the dredge?
Now what the you want a cookie?
Get your hand off that lever.
Todd Hoffman's crew.
I can't work with my dad.
Parker might have won the battle, but we're going to win the war.
Somebody just shot at us out on the road.
Everybody off the mine!
On this, Gold Rush.
I'm getting pretty damn close to pulling the plug down there, actually.
For most places, you wouldn't keep your job withholding that kind of information.
All right, you want me to pack my then?
Shaft this together.
So
they're
gonna
off every thing quits around there.
I got 2 minutes.
2 out.
Give me a break.
Last bucket. We're shutting it down.
Yeah,
Pan, we'll fire this baby back up.
I like it.
Yourself if it's worth running two operations because he's just not paying his bills down there.
Ending the season, Parker Schnabel has mined over 4,200 ounces of gold, worth more than $5 million. But last week, Rick's gold production at Big Red took an unexplained dive, producing less.
The cleanup's dropping off, you know, the gold went from really good to really bad, and that's basically our biggest struggle right now. You know, everything's worked, it's just the gold's not there.
As the Indian River boss, it's down to Rick to deliver half of their 5,000 ounce gold.
Howdy.
I don't know.
It's so serious. Cleanup specialist Chris Neal to respond to the morning's total.
Hey, Rick.
Hello.
I'd like to see how it's going. How much is there to jig or table?
Well,
what? Is that it? Because that's no way to make any money. We need a...
Yeah.
What the... Like, we ain't even paying for sleuthing, though. For the sleuthing.
Look, man, I get it. This is not the plan here, but...
Because I'm getting pretty damn close to pulling the plug down there, actually.
Give me a couple days to get down there and figure out what's going on with the ground. And I'll see what I can do. It's a little shocking, but I get it. You know, if it's not paying the bills, it's not paying the bills, so.
Get back on the gold. Parker will shut his operation down.
You got a copy?
Yeah, man, go ahead.
Yeah, you want to come down on the cot and take a look?
Yeah, I'll be right over.
What's going on, Rick?
Brennan Rule is Rick's most experienced operator.
Spot?
I've been digging here for days. I just don't understand it.
The one thing I do know is that the gold went to and the only explanation rise in bedrock. I mean, standing from here looking at it, this is just like a giant off.
I can see that.
Common sense tells me that a giant ridge like this has got to do something. Whenever the gold came through here, how could this not?
Rick found little gold in the shallow ground above the bedrock ridge that deposited the gold, kept to the deep ground on either side of the ridge. So, very little gold ended up above the ridge. Rick believes the richest pay is on the other side.
Yeah, well, we've been hauling 90% off the valley side, so
if this high
the high side of it, so
side. Let's jump down off the other side, I guess, and see what we got down there. Yeah, it already looks a bit different, doesn't it? Oh, it looks like better material.
I sure hope so, man. I don't want to get shut down here.
Yeah. Well, I'm look at all that.
Oh, man, that's nice cold.
I think we got our answer up here, right? Anyway, we pan up there, there's nothing on this. So in my mind, that side, we focus on the river side, and we're marching that way.
You think Parker's going to be a little pissy about stripping all that and not taking it?
Good. We're going to show a bunch of gold.
High five, brother.
Yeah.
Right on, man.
Sweet. We go where the gold is. Come from where we were hauling from and start making our way towards the river. Do this.
Rick follows his bandit in pay dirt that Parker has spent thousands of dollars stripping. He's taking a risk, changing the mining plan.
I've done this by Parker, obviously, yet, and I don't know that I will. I'm making a decision. You know, I'll worry about Parker later. Right now, all I'm focused on is 100 ounces at the next pit.
By now, we're getting late in the season. We've got the dredge at Pistol Creek. We cannot get a 50-ton crane in. I'll put him up.
Second dredge is still stuck at Thistle Creek, but his two mining operations have delivered over 2,500 ounces of gold. Hit his 3,000-ounce, $3.6 million goal.
Monica's doing great with her wash plant. She's turning out lots of dredge, so we got a good pair of hands on the wheel down there.
You gotta go down a little bit.
Kevin has shut down his dredge to install a video monitoring system.
Like good, Kev?
Focus a tiny. When there's an issue, you can see it right away. Because this way, the operator should be able to stop the problems before they happen. Saves me coming over here.
Hey, Kevin.
What's up?
Why the f*** isn't this thing running?
Because I'm putting the cameras in.
Hi.
Putting the cameras in. Then I'm off to see
the results of that f*** visit.
No, you got enough grandkids.
Hey, well, I don't f*** care. Fix it up, get the f*** thing rolling. We can't make no money.
Kevin has invested $10,000 on 8 cameras that will closely monitor key parts.
You can see down in the hopper there, this is for the ruck chute, trommel camera, and the stacker cam. Looking good.
And on the dredge, Kenny, if you can come up here, take over. I'm going to go clear some tailings quick.
Let's crank it up!
Yep!
Dredge hand Kenny Dave fires her up.
I seen the spray.
Oh. Everywhere.
Who spills gallons of oil out onto the deck.
On the bright side, the vegetable oil that we use in there, it's all biodegradable.
It's the exact same stuff.
This old hose controls the brakes. It's the port side winch. Which means basically that we
wish this line broken.
For every hour Kevin's dredges down, Tony loses around $2,000.
If we're down, we're not dredging, we're not producing gold.
At Eureka Creek, a burst hydraulic hose brings Kevin's dredge to a standstill.
And how the cameras could have drained the whole hydraulic tank, so at least they caught it as quick as they did.
Good. The whole thing out to do a whole new length, and we ain't got that.
Getting a new 150-foot hydraulic hose, 2 days.
Luckily, I'm a cheap smart, so I'm just gonna splice a new piece in.
If I cut it where it's already cut, it should make less of a mess that way.
Cool. Alright.
I'm gonna a joint iron between the two. Now we're hooking it up. Off we go.
That's good.
Cameras are in. I'm gonna take a few days off to see the girlfriend. So it's gonna be your problem for a while.
Good. Oh, power. Sure, we'll get the guys to run it. Like you say, everybody can do it. So we'll see you in a couple days.
Sounds like a plan.
Ignored him and abandoned ground.
He's on the book to find a lot of gold, but for me, we've got to pay the bills. You know, we've spent a lot of money stripping this ground, we're spending a lot of money sluicing it, and the ground's not worth mining. Then him and I have to discuss that. Like, the buck stops with me. I'm the one losing money here. Heard you're not mining all the ground we stripped? What the f***?
That part of the cot was worthless. I don't know what you want me to do.
Well, coming to me would probably be a first step.
Yeah.
So when were you planning on telling me, or were you not?
This is the second time you've changed the mining plan without talking to me.
That ain't okay, Rick.
Yeah.
Like, that ain't. Like, most places you wouldn't keep your job over hold withhold. Would you?
As a foreman, I don't think you would.
All right, you want me to pack my then?
That's not what I'm saying, Rick. I'm just saying that you don't seem to take it
seriously. Alive. The gold was dropping off, and you put a lot of pressure on us this week. You know what I mean? It's not like I was just going to let it continue. And yeah, again, going forward, I'll run everything by you first. I'm just trying to make us more money.
It comes back to communication, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, and just to give you a heads up, if this next gold weigh isn't above 100 ounces, we're gonna have to Okay.
Hill that we were really counting on is just taking a dump. It's not good.
Delivered less than 40 ounces, a sign that the pastry could be running out.
Yeah, the guys at the wash plant aren't super big fans of this pay. There's no point in running just to run. You have to have gold in the dirt that you're running for it to be worth your while.
How's it looking?
Like it, it's just not very good at all.
Todd's dad, Jack, is doing Monster Red's daily cleaning.
Inside here, there's no gold.
What's your guess? What do you think we're going to do?
It's going to be maybe three. No more than that.
Give me a break.
That didn't even pay for fuel.
All right.
Todd has yet to break even and can't afford to run Monster Red at a loss.
Hey, what's up?
Last bucket. We're going to shut down. We're done. We're shutting it down.
Okay.
Shut it down. Guys, everybody meet over at Monster Red. Plants at 10 bucks a yard minimum. We're at 3 bucks a yard here. I can't sit here and lose money. Put the wagons around fair play and do that.
This makes absolutely no sense to me. We've been waiting the whole season to get 3 plants running, and now that we have 3 running.
Trey Paulson first discovered the gold streak up on Sluice Box Hill.
You have to prospect.
I know there's gold over there, but to find it, it's too many guys, it's too more machines. We're shrinking, we're not growing.
I disagree. Can't give up on Sluice Box Hill, we just have to search around for more pay.
All right, here's the deal. If you can find me a good gold pan up on Sluice Box Hill, we'll fire. All right, guys, let's get to work.
Try and get this little section up here cleared out and see if there's any gold in the ground up here. If I can just produce red, is back in business.
To break even this season, Trey believes they need 3 plants running. He's pay at the top of Sluice Box Hill.
Hi, Uncle Jim.
While Trey digs, Jim Thurber.
What got going on, Trey?
So, I think this is going to be the same pay as what's in Sluice Box Hill. I'm hoping
dig the holes. I'll give you a report on what's in them.
Trey digs down.
I like it.
It's the right stuff. Let's see if we can find some gold. So this bucket's 4 feet down.
Okay, well, let's go pan it.
Trey, talk to Trey. Punch it deeper. Let's go down to about 18 or 20 feet deep.
I'll go deeper. Son of a gun, that's not good.
There's a pay layer in there somewhere, but deep.
There you go. That's a good one. That's good.
Down to 20. Go ahead, Todd. No, that's not good. Trey, deeper. Yeah, what's up?
Yeah, Holy Roller's broken down again. I don't know what's going on, but we're probably going to be shut down for a while.
10-4. This is actually getting pretty scary. It needs to be in this next layer. I'm hoping and praying it's in this next layer.
Yeah, that's it, isn't it, Andy?
Looks different.
What depth is this?
The deepest.
25,
30 feet. Sure you're panning this right?
Well, it doesn't look that right.
Trey, do you want to head down here? Where we're... Out of all those pans...
From Monster Reds, that's what you're saying?
I think we have no other choice.
I thought we'd be fine up there on Sluice Box Hill, up top, but...
This season... Monster Red has mined 727 ounces of gold, worth almost 875 pod, calls time on his trusty plant.
It'd probably be better if I just took some money and just threw it, that amount of gold at my backyard, at my house. Not good.
Kevin is away. So far, it's looking not too bad. Get some gold, put some money in your pocket.
Tony's son, Kevin, is taking time off, visiting his girlfriend.
She works better than she ever...
Dredge, in the hands of relief crew, Jason Smith, and Vitsa Anuma.
You can call me a dredge master as well. I've never asked you enough time that I think I probably could, you know?
You got absolutely no power. All at once like that for no reason. There is a safety line on the stackers. You can see if somebody tripped that. If they did, then it shuts everything down.
Jason and
me.
Yeah, I don't know where the we're gonna put it all.
Rock got through. It got stuck in here and then backed up everything. It doesn't take long for the...
We'll be digging for days, man.
We got new cameras everywhere on here, but can't see anything back here on the camera.
There's a bunch of not a good situation.
Oh, I don't know. It looks like that bearing's.
Oh, it is too. Well, I'd be wrong, but I think the bearing's shot up top. And on the other side too, if you take a gander on the other side.
A more serious problem with the stacker that calls for a second opinion.
Tony, you got a copy? If it's shot or if it's good?
I got Kev on rig this thing up so everybody go around this dredge.
Thanks.
I got shaft this, so get out of there. So they're Kev off to go see his girlfriend. What happens? Every in this dredge taking gold.
For the second time in 2 days, Kevin's dredge is shut down.
David, there. That dredge is like we lost a couple bearings. No, I ain't gonna do it. Whose dredge is it? I'll have a plane at the airport pick you up. Basically, just please get the over there so we can get that thing digging, okay? Good. See you in the morning.
They'd have the most peaceful week ever, or everything would go to so of course everything would go to
at Eureka Creek. A visit to his girlfriend in order to fix his dredge.
Son is gonna be, and then this one is about here.
He has to conveyor's drive roller.
Ready? That's why I don't hold on very tight. Just get this bearing down to here where the old marks are. Second set has got to go here-ish. I'm just gonna put it back in put to go. It's moving. 2,000 more hits and it'll be at the bottom.
The you guys doing? Saying a prayer over a thing or what?
Yep.
So you're nicely gonna beat the out of the bearing?
Wait a minute. We got it this far.
You got two hammers?
I got another brass one.
Okay, we'll get it. That shows the size of the pecker on any man. How to hold the hammer or how to pull a cam along. Yeah. You see these guys that go up the cam along, they're used to short stamina like that, yeah. Short stroke. Now, if you got real guys,
give me the thing.
Right? Show the world what you can do. Oh. You want to know something funny?
What's that?
Something back?
Well, I'll take it. We'll just turn it around.
Pretty good to have Kevin back out there. Should be back in business.
The bearings are on, bolted in place.
There, you're in the hole. You're in.
Okay, well, she's in. Cool. Hey. Right, so she's all in, everything's tight. All we gotta do is turn it on.
Put your hands out of the way.
Yeah, we're all clear?
Yeah, fire up.
Good job, Gavin.
I'll leave it up to you. Keep that running.
All right, she's all fixed. Fire up, boys.
back working. Get some of the gold out of the ground, make some money.
Sure, Tony realizes now that, dude, I got too many skills. There's not enough for me to go around.
Parker's mining plant.
You know, I'm not real enthused about how it all went down there, but
yeah, exactly. You
know, hopefully it worked, Rick. That's mm-hmm. all I've got to say. Well, let's see what Big Red's got.
At least 100 ounces. Parker will shut Rick down.
All right, Rick.
There you go.
Yeah,
I think it's there.
Here's 150. There's two. 26.
425,000 dollars worth of gold.
Nice. Well done.
Yours, Big Red's future.
Wow, that's a job, man.
And proves Rick made the right call. At Slucifer, Parker's regularly been getting over 100 ounce cleanups.
A pile of
gold. What?
Yeah. 60, 80, over 100.
200.
200. Oh.
Worth well over $300,000.
This is the first time Big Red has ever. For the season, we're at 4,894 ounces.
Oh.
Parker is just over 105,000 ounce, $6 million season gold.
It feels good. It was a long time coming. Where's our drinks?
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
Killing it. Next week, 5,000. It really couldn't come at a better time. Like, we were starting to get pretty 5,000, and now it's, you know, we just broke its back.
It's feeling good to come out on the winning side of things with that. You know, had to make some decisions this week, and those don't always go well. Hit a grand slam with that, so.
You, Bedrock, huh?
Up ahead.
Oh, I was going to say not come back.
Oh, really?
Todd bought Monster Red for 300 ounces of gold. Here's, it's mine. Over 4,800, worth $5.5 million. Twenty-nine-year-old Kevin Beats started dating university student Faith.
Started seeing her this year, but we've known each other for quite a few years now. Started to hang out more, started to date, stopped dating, then started dating, so we're dating. I know I'm all mushy. She'd be really happy if she sees any of the marks she left on me on the telly I'm just in. 20 hickeys. There's over 20. Well, they're not on me now. That was when she came up for a visit. There's a human heart in here somewhere. It's hiding down.
Hey, guys. I've been waiting for you.
At Eureka Creek, after Tony ordered Kevin back from his romance, the Beats family prepares for their weekly weigh-in.
Do you guys make any money?
I'm going to tell you this right now.
Good, you tell me.
Girlfriend.
No.
It's just nothing but a pain in the ass.
I come back, everything's broke.
The next time you might be smarter not to leave at all.
I was going to say not.
How did you do?
Not terribly great.
Hmm?
Yeah, that's a lot of sleuthing hours we lost.
You're going to have like that. That in a prep or whatever.
Yeah.
You're going to have no matter what. Let's see what you got.
Tony needs another 400, his 3,000 ounce season gold.
60, 70, 80. So that's not man.
Worth just over $108,000.
So how do you make out this week, Monica?
Going the whole time, so.
So what do you want to do? Weigh it up, see what you got?
Come on.
20, 80, 100. 112.2.
Worth 134,000.
Well, you know, Kevin, I beat you this week, but if you would have been running, you easily would have beat me. What's the total for the whole works?
2,774.
Hey, Kevin.
This week's haul means the Beats family is just 225 ounces from hitting Tony's $3,000 goal.
I think we should all go back to work, to tell you the truth. I mean, You guys have to go back to the barge. You both have to go sluicing. I'm the calculator operator. And I do very well. And I sleep at the bus so I can boss everybody around. That's my prerogative.
Oh, yeah.
Hey guys, I'm gonna be honest with you, it wasn't a good week. But I know we got some gold.
Todd has abandoned his season goal of 5,000 ounces. To simply break even, he needs ounces a week.
What's going on over there, Holy Roller?
We didn't even pull mats, no cleanups at all, so zero gold out.
It's having a lot of issues because it's a brand new plant. You know, we've been just fixing those and trying to get the plant dialed in.
And, 5 ounces.
Worth just $4,000 for its final day of running.
I wanted to run 3 plants, but we've dug that property and we're finding gold everywhere, just not enough to go after. I was wrong.
Monster Red down.
Both plants have failed to deliver. The pressure's on Rusty Red to take them over the line.
Yes, sir. Rusty Red is 45.75.
At this rate, at least Todd is on track.
Fair play. Keep Rusty Red as the primary. And then try to get Holy Roller running. Know that we've had a lot of issues. But you know what? It's how we deal with them. Super thankful to be a part of this team with you guys. Get some rest and hit it in the morning, huh?
I do. Resources together. Move over to Fair Play and see what we can do.
You know, Holy Roller, I believe that that's the future, and I believe we're possibly any other plant that we've ever had.
You should say deal is a deal a lot.
Gold Rush.
Tony's runway is right up here.
Holy! Look out! I'm shutting off the plant. I'm getting gold right now.
Just fix it and get it running.
Rip the park, get it ready. Right.
Whoa. You know they left.
Watch out. Lift the damn thing up.
Xin chào mọi người. Chào mừng mọi người đã đến với kênh đọc sách báo chuyện mình. Hôm nay chúng ta sẽ cùng nhau đọc một đầu báo có tựa đề là năm ca sĩ chấp nhận bỏ mặc idol 10 năm để làm một điều. Và chia sẻ Jimin BTS thu hút sự chú ý từ người hâm mộ. Để xem anh ấy chia sẻ gì. Vừa qua, Jimin đánh dấu một tài xuất solo với album cá nhân thứ hai mang tên Muse. Sau một trong lúc tạm dừng hoạt động với đội ngũ, Jimin vẫn cố gắng mang được trải nghiệm trọn vẹn cho fan. Men Dancer của BTS quảng bá album mới với 2 MV hoành tráng, biểu diễn trên sóng truyền hình Mỹ và chuẩn bị nhiều content quay sẵn. Jimin đã đánh dấu hoàn tái xuất solo với album cá nhân thứ hai mang tên Muse và đây là hình ảnh minh họa của anh. Trên kênh YouTube của BTS, cuộc trò chuyện giữa Jimin và trưởng nhóm RM được đăng tải thu hút sự quan tâm của các ARMY. Bọn tôi cùng nhau ngồi lại nói về quá trình Jimin chuẩn bị album Muse và những sự kiện quan trọng trong suốt thời gian quảng bá độc lập. Đáng chú ý, Jimin đã có những chia sẻ chân thành về việc học hát hoặc ồn ào encore thảm họa. Và Jimin đã gặp nhiều áp lực trong lần đầu quảng bá solo do vấn đề về giọng hát của anh. Cụ thể khi được RM về sự kiện quan trọng làm thay đổi Jimin nhiều nhất trong khoảng thời gian từ năm 2022 đến 2023. Nhưng chẳng nên đang sợ không ngại khẳng định đeo đạch quảng bá Andrew Face. Lần đầu, debut solo không còn màng bảo vệ các thành viên. Jimin đã cỡ gàng và lúng túng. Anh như lừa phép bộ mặt cũ của mình để nhìn lại từng stage trình diễn, cách hát, những bước nhảy. Và đây là cuộc trò chuyện giữa Jimin và RM. Và Jimin chia sẻ anh đã học hát lại từ đầu và chỉ nói chuyện này cho Trung Quốc. Và Jimin đã tâm sự chuyện học hát này cho RM này. Jimin cho biết bản thân đã học khớp lại từ đầu và chỉ nói chuyện này cho em với Trung Quốc. Có thể quá muộn nhưng mình nghĩ là đã muộn. Em vẫn muốn tự cải thiện mình. Em dường như chỉ nói việc này với Trung Quốc. Em cảm thấy được hát theo cách cũ thì sẽ không tốt cho giọng em. Đây cũng là điều giáo viên đã nói. Em đọc những điều cơ bản để có thể hát live mà không tổn thương đến giọng. Đó là điều cốt lõi là điều em đã học lại từ thứ đầu tiên. Rồi khi thực hiện những động tác nền tảng đạo vậy. Em đang nghĩ việc làm sao để tập luyện khi nhập ngũ, Jimin chia sẻ với RM. Thời điểm quảng bá Like Crazy, Jimin đã gây nên tranh cãi cực lớn khi được lộ yếu điểm hát live trên single Encore. Video Jimin Encore đã thu hút 40 triệu lượt xem trên Twitter. Vừa phải bão bình luận tiêu cực, Jimin bị gắn mác Encore thảm họa, nhận về lời chiều chỉ trích về kỹ năng yếu giữa hoạt động chuyên nghiệp 10 năm. Đây cũng là một trong ôn hàng lớn nhất sự nghiệp của Men Dancer nhà BTS. Và Jim Rin đã chấp nhận bỏ qua thâm niên 10 năm để bắt đầu học hát từ đầu. Không giải thích dài dòng, Jim Rin âm thầm luyện tập, chia sẻ trên kênh của Nam Idol để các ARMY đồng cảm, để lại nhiều cổ vũ. Với chiếc thềm nhập ngũ, Jim Rin vẫn canh cắn trong lòng chuyện làm sao để cải thiện giọng hát. Và chấp nhận bỏ qua thâm niên 10 năm để bắt đầu học lại từ đầu. Đấy chứ, nỗ lực cực kỳ đáng, ghi nhận. Được đúng không ạ? Giọng của Jim Rin nói là giọng kiểu cực kỳ đặc biệt luôn, nghe dần là khó quên, mà nghĩ là anh này có vấn đề trong sự giọng, cái này không thể nhận được 100% luôn. Nên là nếu anh em có thể cải thiện chất giọng thì kiểu rất là ok. Vậy ok mà không được. Kiểu giọng này anh này là kiểu đặc biệt, nên là kiểu hiếm rồi. Từ bắt trước được trong K-pop nên là mình nghĩ là nếu cải thiện được là không gì bằng luôn. Chúng ta sẽ chờ xem sau khi nhập ngũ thì anh ấy sẽ như thế nào. Các bạn cũng phải chờ từ giờ 2025 mới biết được. Nhiều thời gian mà cứ chờ thôi. Nhớ là có thời mình xem video nào kiểu các đàn em đã cover nhạc của BTS ấy, kiểu không cover mà mọi người bị giọng của Jimin kiểu ở một âm vực khá là cao mà nghe cũng rất đặc biệt. Thầy cũng chỉ có kiểu nghe vậy mình đã đọc xong đầu báo ngày hôm nay dành cho mọi người. Cảm ơn mọi người đã theo dõi video này của mình. Còn bây giờ thì xin chào và hẹn gặp lại mọi người ở những video tiếp theo nha. Ok, bye bye mọi người.